Number four, al-inqiyad, to follow. Because some people will say, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, and some people don't come to the salah in the masjid. And some people don't say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, or sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when we say Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we said last time, to send salah and salam on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is of a huge benefit to us. And everyone who says, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, it goes to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knows it, and he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will reply. And his name will be mentioned in the heavens, and the malaika will know his name or her name. And people don't follow. So an inqiyad is not easy. Inqiyad from qada, to lead something. If you have an animal and you lead it this way, it comes with you. You lead it that way, it comes with you. So it's just submissive to you. This is the inqiyad. So we have to be submissive to the deen. When I do something and somebody mentioned ayah to me that it is against what I'm doing, I should leave it immediately. We should leave it. Oh, I'm not doing something, I think it is not from Islam, but somebody gets me an ayah, hadith, and say this is from the sunnah, I go and do it. This is the inqiyad. We submit ourselves to the will of Allah and to the will of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this, our shahada cannot be complete until we have this inqiyad that we have to Allah and to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَنْ يُسْلِمْ وَجْهَهُ لِلَّهِ وَهُوَ مُحْسِنْ فَقَالِ اسْتَمْسَكَ بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى. Whoever submits his face to Allah doing good, he has been taken hold of the strong rope of Allah. The ulama said al-urwat al-wuthqa is La ilaha illallah. So when we submit ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have held the robe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that will take us to Jannah and to Rahmah and Maghfirah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يكون هواه تبعا لما جئت به. None of you will believe until his hawa, his desires, will be going with what I came up with. Your desires, temptations, your needs should be going with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Going with the Quran and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we have inqiyad, taslim. We just submit ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And even our hawa, not just the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't say his action. He said his hawa. Whatever he has in his mind, desires, needs, attitudes, whatever he has here, it has to be with, going with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If it is not, the Prophet is saying, لا يؤمن, he is not a mu'min. He is a Muslim, saying, لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله, but he is not going to the level of Iman, which is above Islam. Iman is another level of Islam, it is higher than Islam, so he is not a mu'min. Who doesn't go with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number five, as-sidqu, truthfulness. To say la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah and to have this sidq in your heart about this shahada. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains in Surah Al-Ankabut, Alif lam mim, ahasiba an-nas an yutraku an yaqulu amanna wa hum la yuftanun wa laqad fatanna alladhina min qablihim. فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, the people they come to Islam and they believe, don't they think that they will be tested? They will be tested so we can know and sort out the truthful ones from the ones who are not truthful. Because if deen is just saying, we say, لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله, and there is no action, this will not be good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, you will be tested to sort out the good from the bad, the truthful ones, the ones who are not truthful. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another ayah, لِيَمِيزَ اللَّهُ الْخَبِيثَ مِنَ الطَّيِّبِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to distinguish and sort out the khabith, the bad, out of the good. How? With tests. The ones who will succeed and win in these tests are the sadiqun, the Muslim as-sadiq, the truthful Muslim. And Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith that Mu'az ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu narrates, ما من أحد يشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله صدقا من قلبه إلا حرمه الله على النار. Hadith Sahih, said Mu'az, saying the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, whoever says لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله truthfully from his heart, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make his body forbidden to go to Jannah. It is haram for him to go to Jahannam, li'adhu billah. His body and himself will be forbidden to go to Jahannam, the Nar. Meaning what? He will be going to Jannah. Why? Because he's saying, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, sidqan, truthfully, from his heart. So he is forbidden to go to Jahannam. Imagine that if we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this belief, and we have this strong belief, and the kalima of La ilaha illallah is very strong in our hearts, and we are truthful and certain, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the glad tidings of Jannah. Even if we do some things, we are sinful, we are sure that if we go to Jahannam, it will be for a short time just to clean up our misses. And we hope in the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that will encompass everything, that He subhanahu wa ta'ala inshallah will forgive our sins because of our sidq, our truthfulness, and our yaqeen, our certainty in kalimat al-tawheed, la ilaha illallah, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala will make us forbidden to go to Jahannam, inshallah will go to Jannah. So think about it, sidq, to be sadiq, to be truthful, la ilaha illallah, it's major, it's a condition. Shahada cannot be complete without being truthful. Truthful with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the ibadat and the mu'amalat with other people. Deal with them the way that you want people to deal with you. Love for your brother and sister what you want them to love for you. Smile at their faces. Try to help people. Be a truthful mu'min and a truthful Muslim and Muslima. Then the truthful of Islam will come into the heart. And then we will be eligible to go in the category of that hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make us forbidden to go to Jahannam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be among those that their bodies and themselves are forbidden to go to Jahannam, and inshallah will be forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and going to Jannah. Ameen. So this is number five, as-sidq, truthfulness. Number six is al-ikhlas, sincerity. When we say la ilaha illallah, we have to be away from shirk. Ikhlas negates shirk. If I am a mukhlas, sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so I don't have anyone else. It doesn't have to be an idol I worship, or someone or something I worship. It can be my desire, my temptation, my shaitan. I can worship my shaitan and myself. Some people just believe in themselves to the extent that they don't believe in anyone else. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ Even Allah and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They just believe in what they believe, themselves. So this ikhlas, sincerity in kalimat tawheed, will take us away from shirk. And shirk, as we know, is major shirk, which is taking anyone with Allah. And minor shirk, many actions that we can do and we may do in everyday life, it will be considered shirk and we don't know. So we have to be careful. When we say La ilaha illallah, it has to be sincerely going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, Ala lillahi dinul khalis. Isn't for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the sincere religion? And also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Qul illaha a'budu mukhlisan lahu dini. Say, I worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely. Just Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the kalimat at-tawheed, it has to have this sixth condition of ikhlas. And number seven, which is the before we go to number seven, the last one, Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu says about this ikhlas, the hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, a very beautiful hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أسعد الناس بشفاعتي من قال لا إله إلا الله خالصا من قلبه أو خالصا من نفسه. أسعد الناس بشفاعتي. The most happiest Muslim with my intercession.
the intercession of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We said last time, when you make salah and salam on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inshallah you will be given the shafa'ah. You will be included in shafa'at the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, when everybody is busy with his own business of hasanat and sayyat, and nobody can intercede from Adam to Isa. It's Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam who will intercede for his ummah. And if you make salah and salam on him a lot, you will be included in this shafa'ah. And then here, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, if you say la ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, sincerely from your heart, you are going to be included in my shafa'ah, the shafa'ah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this is also about ikhlas. The last condition is al-mahabba, love. To say la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah out of love. Because some people and some religious preachers or imams or du'a, they always teach the Muslims about Jahannam and the troubles in Jahannam and the ways that people will be in Jahannam. And they never talk to the Muslims about the beautifulness of Jannah, the beauty of Jannah and the good things in Islam. So some people worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out of fear. They are scared of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I was just told last week a very like story that if you hear, it is very intimidating and it will give you big sorrow. You will be a hazin in your heart. A Muslim family coming from a Muslim country, and their father was too strict to his children, that almost everything is haram, until the wife and the children, they leave the father and they get out to a non-Muslim country and they live in that place. And some of these children, they converted into Christianity because of their father. Subhanallah. This is a true story. They leave Islam, they just leave the whole country because of the father. He was very strict. No, this is haram, that's haram, this is haram, that's haram, there is nothing halal. So the children, when they grow up, they took the mother and they left. Not just this, they left Islam and they went to Christianity. Can you imagine this? A Muslim country, and even Arabs. So Arabs, sometimes they have some favor that they have the language of the Quran and the Sunnah. And the children left Islam just because of the father. He was very strict. And unfortunately, some people use this way always to scare people. Jahannam is so and so. Before we teach people about Jahannam, we teach them about the beauty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the kalimat tawheed, la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. And we see the ulama, they say, our iman has to be balanced around three basics. Fear, to be afraid of the punishment if you do something bad. Love, to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and worship Him out of love. Hope, that you hope if you do something bad, He is the most forgiving subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why did He call Himself Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim subhanahu wa ta'ala? He called Himself Ar-Rahman, the most gracious, the most merciful, because He is merciful subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us the hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created rahmah and rahim and mercy 100 parts, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala sent one part to this world with which the animals will take its hoof away from its baby not to harm him. And with this one part of rahmah, we are merciful to one another. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala saved 99 parts of His rahmah today, the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. Why? Inshallah, to be merciful with us. And to have His rahmah and His maghfirah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is subhanahu wa ta'ala al-afu, al-wadud, the most loving. One of Allah's name, al-wadud. He's not just loving His servants, He comes closer from them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala takes any way to come to His servant. As we see in many hadith, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, that when you come closer from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like a hand span, He will come closer from you, an arm span. If you come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, walk into Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will come running to you. Imagine this. He's the Lord. He doesn't need us. We need him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, he, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the most loving. And he comes closer from his servants, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So our ibadah should be coming out of love. And you just think about somebody who is working to someone in a company or a business, and he loves his boss. Loves him means respects him. He has a very good relationship with him. He will be always on top of his work. He will never be late for anything. And whatever duties he is given, he will do it before time. Why? Because he has this relationship with his boss. He doesn't want his boss to look at him down or to see that he is not doing good. So out of love for a human to a human can do anything. And we can go far and see in the back in the history and see some men, they love some women. And they can do whatever they tell them to do. And it's just a bond of love between two humans. What can you imagine if we try to achieve the bond of love between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When he loves us subhanahu wa ta'ala and he calls Jibreel alayhi salam and mentions our name, Jibreel, I love so and so, you love him. And Jibreel alayhi salam will call in the heavens, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves so and so, and he will mention the name. And everybody in the heavens, the angels will know the name. And then the acceptance will be put for him or her on earth. Whatever he goes or whatever he says or she says will be accepted. Why? Because he has a connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mahabbah. To say la ilaha illallah and you love to say it. Because some people, they may make you hate kalimat al-tawheed, la ilaha illallah, wal'adhu billah. Because of the instruction they are given every time and they push and they scare you. Especially with the children. They try to give them, you have to do that, you have to do that. This is haram, this is haram. We should give them instructions, but in a good way, in a nice way. We should let our children come to the classes, come to the halaqat, come to the salah, out of love. We want to start and establish this bond of love between them and Kitabullah, the Quran, and the bond of love between them and the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the sunnah. When it comes out of love, they will do whatever you may not be able to do as a Muslim, and they will surprise you. But if you keep pushing them, we can see as these examples, people will leave Islam just because somebody was scaring them from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-wadud. So to be coming to him out of love, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَن يَتَّخِذُ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ أَنْدَادًا يُحِبُّونَهُمْ كَحُبِّ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. Some of the people will take partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they love them more than Allah. But وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those who believe, that's why we want to be included in that category. أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. They love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so much. So when we love him subhanahu wa ta'ala so much, we do not want him to see us in the place of ma'asiyah. We don't want to let him down when he subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us instructions and obligations. So we want always to be on top in the ibadah, obligations and then sunan, nawafil. When we love him subhanahu wa ta'ala, we can do anything and the ibadah will be easy for me and you. When we love him subhanahu wa ta'ala, we'll wake up at night, in the middle of the night, when it is winter time and it is like maybe a minus 20 or 30. And then we will make wudu and we will stand in front of him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Out of love. Because fear may not do this. To scare people, they may not do that. But when it comes out of love, when you leave everything in this life and you come to him subhanahu wa ta'ala, he subhanahu wa ta'ala will be with you. And this love, bond of love, if we achieve it, we will be winners in this life and in the afterlife, inshallah. So this is the last condition of shahadat al-tawheed or kalimat al-tawheed, saying la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. And out of our thanks that we should give to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to know what does it mean by la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. We have to achieve these seven conditions, because most of the ulama al-Islam and the scholars, they agree that these conditions are very important, they are crucial, they are vital, that we have to achieve them to be a real Muslims. The first of which, I will just get them very quick, al-ilm, knowledge, then yaqeen, certainty, then qabool, acceptance, then inqiyad, submissiveness, then as-sidq, truthfulness, then al-ikhlas, sincerity, then al-mahabbah, love. To love this kalima, and then when you love it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah, will help all of us to come closer from Him. So, this is also the last condition, the hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says about this. لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من ولده ووالده والناس أجمعين. None of you will believe until I, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, will become more beloved to him than his parents, his children, and all the people. So if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are not beloved to us more than our families and our children and everything in this life, our iman is incomplete. Only we may not be a mu'min. Another beautiful hadith in Sahih Bukhari, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, ثَلَاثٌ مَنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ وَجَدَ حَلَاوَةَ الْإِيمَانِ. Three things, if they come to you, you will find the sweetness of iman. The first one, مَنْ كَانَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولُهُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْهِ مِمَّا سِوَاهُمَا. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger will be most beloved to Him than anything, so he can taste, or she can taste, the sweetness of Islam and iman. The second one, وَنْ يُحِبَّ الْمَرْأَ لَا يُحِبُّهُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. And to love his brother and sister in Islam, and this love just for Allah, for the sake of Allah. لا يحب المرء يحبه just for Allah سبحانه وتعالى إلا لله. The last one, وأن يكره أن يعود في الكفر بعد أن أنقذه الله منه كما يكره أن يقذف في النار. And he will hate, or she will hate, to go back to kufr after Allah سبحانه وتعالى saved him or her from being a disbeliever, as he or she hates to go to the fire. So these three conditions, if we achieve them, we can taste the sweetness of iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be most beloved to me and you and his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then we can taste the sweetness of iman. We love each other just for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no business between us. There is no relationship between us. We have a relationship that is most stronger than the blood relationship, which is the relationship of Islam and Iman. إنما المؤمنون إخوة. Really, truly, surely, the mu'mins are brothers. So we should love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so He subhanahu wa ta'ala will love us. And when we come and say these seven conditions, they have to be achieved in our lives. To thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to know about Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we come to the second part of shahada, ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, this is also another part of our shahada. We declare that He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the Messenger of Allah. And this declaration, this witness also has conditions that we have to love Him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we have to follow Him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Say, if you really love Allah, follow me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you your sins. And also we have to know that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when we say ashhadu, we witness, we testify, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Himself, He was a shaheed before us, that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the most beloved of his creation, and he is the Prophet and Messenger of Allah. And also the angels were witnessing that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Rasulullah, and the Anbiya and the Rasul, the Prophets and Messengers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took the oath upon all of them before Muhammad comes, that when he comes, they will all believe in him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he sallallahu alayhi subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَ النَّبِيِّينَ لَمَا آتَيْتُكُمْ مِنْ كِتَابٍ وَحِكْمَةٍ ثُمَّ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مُصَدِّقٌ لِمَا مَعَكُمْ لَتُؤْمِنُنَّ بِهِ وَلَتَنْصُرُنَّهُ قَالَ أَأَقْرَرْتُمْ وَأَخَذْتُمْ عَلَى ذَلِكُمْ إِصْرِي قَالُوا أَقْرَرْنَا قَالَ فَاشْهَدُوا وَأَنَا مَعَكُمْ مِنَ الشَّاهِدِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is a very important ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He took the oath from the Nabiyeen, the Prophets, when I gave you the kitab and the hikmah, the books and the wisdom, and then will come after you or among you a rasul musaddiqun lima ma'akum. What he is coming up with will agree with what you came up with. Musaddiqun lima ma'akum. لَتُؤْمِنُنَّ بِهِ. You will believe in him. وَلَتَنْصُرُنَّهُ. You will support him. قَالَ أَقْرَرْتُمْ. Do you confirm this? وَأَخَذْتُمْ عَلَى ذَلِكُمْ إِصْرِي. And you take the oath on that? قَالُوا أَقْرَرْنَا. The Nabiyeen, the prophets and the messengers, they said, we confess, we testify, we declare that when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam comes, we believe in him. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrects all the prophets and messengers to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the rite of Isra and Mi'raj, to be the Imam al-Mursaleen. Not just saying it, to be practically the Imam in Masjid al-Aqsa, and to be the last of them and the youngest of them, and to be the leader of them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, went to a Masjid al-Aqsa, and he found all the prophets and messengers, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he took the oath on them before him, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to confirm to the whole world, and to confirm to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself, that they are followers of you, Muhammad. Although they are prophets and messengers, they are following you. So if we want to believe and say we are saying La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah without following Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, without taking his sunnah and making it easy in our life, we don't make the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam difficult for us and our children and our wives to achieve and to practice. If we want to do this, we should love him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we should follow him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then we achieve the conditions of this kalima. And I will end with Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah. He says, وَأَمَّا الْإِيمَانُ بِالرَّسُولِ فَهُوَ الْمُهِمُ. About the iman in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's very important. إِذْ لَا يَتِمُّ الْإِيمَانِ بِدُونِ الْإِيمَانِ بِهِ. Our iman cannot be complete until we believe in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَا تَحْصُلُ النَّجَاةُ وَالسَّعَادَةُ بِدُونِهِ. And we will not be saved, and we will not be happy in this life and afterlife except with him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِذْ هُوَ الطَّرِيقُ إِلَى اللَّهِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is our way to Allah. If we want to take a way to Allah, it will be through Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلِهَذَا كَانَ رُكْنَ الْإِسْلَامِ. And for that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it part of the rukn of al-Islam. When we say, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. So thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to thank him subhanahu wa ta'ala and give our thanks to him, we have to know our deen, we have to know our Lord, we have to know our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How come we follow somebody and we don't know him? If you follow some man or woman in this life and you don't know his history, this will be something ridiculous. So what about following in our life and afterlife? It is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We should read his seerah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, know about his sahaba radiallahu alayhim, know his etiquettes and manners, as Aisha radiallahu anha, she summarized and she said, if you want to see the Quran walking on the face of the earth, look at Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik alayka sayyidi ya Rasulullah, inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت على الحق أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تذق قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، وجزاكم الله خيرا.